on the ranking. One title, the Indonesian Premier event. So to his opponent, the 21-year-old Srikanth Kidambi, the number four seed. Up a couple of places in the world ranking this week to number six. And one title, the China Open.
So let's hear it from the players. First on top level,
the European champion, Jan Jorgensen. Number two seed. And if he's to qualify, he has to win this match. Because whilst he beat Tommy Sugiyato on Wednesday, yesterday he lost to Kento Momota in three games, an hour and 6 minutes, 21-12 in the deciding game. But what a run of good form for the number four seed, Srikanth Kidambi. Listen to the fans. Plenty of Indian support. We heard it earlier for Saina Nehwal, and we're going to have a repeat here for Srikanth Kidambi, the man who made history, the first male player from India to qualify for the men's singles at the Super Series finals. Jan Jorgensen.
Okay.
Yeah, he's quite a character with his body art and his ponytail, his long stockings. Yeah, well, I think I heard Jan Jorgensen saying that he was choosing side, this side. So the number two against the number four seed, Jan Jorgensen, European champion, up against Srikanth Kidambi. Well, who would have thought 12 months ago the Indian player was ranked 47 in the world, and here he is almost at the end of the year, and he's number six in the world ranking. What a season he's had. Won the China Super Series, beating the great Lin Dan, the two-time Olympic champion, five-time world champion Lin Dan, in that final in Fujian province. Also reached the final of his home Grand Prix gold event in Lucknow. 11 Super Series tournaments throughout the year, finishing the Destination Dubai list at number five. Not only that one title, but two semi-finals as well. Two matches played, two matches won against Momota and Sugiyato. Momota, he had to go to three games, and that may become significant if Jan Jorgensen, the European champion, could win this match in two straight games. A world ranking of three. He played just 10 of the 12 Super Series events, so one less than his opponent. He withdrew from the Australian event, having won the China Premier event the week before. Semi-finalist in the last of the Super Series events, the Hong Kong, despite being number two seed. Well, he beat Tommy Sugiyato on Wednesday, 21-15, 21-9, and then yesterday lost to Momoto, having won the opening game, 22-20, then lost 21-18, 21-12 in an hour and 6 minutes. But this is the third meeting between these two players. Honours are shared of the previous two, one win apiece. So Anang Sukadra of Indonesia and Bert van Korenbeek from Belgium, our umpire and service judge. Well, I suppose the significance, the last time these two players met was back in 2013. So some considerable time ago, and before the meteoric rise of Srikanth Kidambi. but it was the Indian player that won on that occasion. But it was home soil. It was the first round
Ladies
of the India Super Series last
year.
Right,
Jan Jorgensen, Denmark. On the left, Srikanth, India. Srikanth to serve, let all play.
The 21-year-old from Guntur in India getting this match underway.
Set is over.
Morten, I don't know if you've heard anything through the grapevine as we have a quick look at Pulela Gopichand, the India coach, but have you spoken to Jan Jorgensen or any of the Danes about how he's feeling about today's match? He knows he has to win.
He knows he's got to win, yes, but as I understand it, they're quite happy with the fact that Momota play three games, and therefore, should Jan win, I think he's standing very good chances of qualifying. I think that Momota will possibly be the one that's not going to the semi-final, even though all three players then would have two wins.
Yeah.
So in that way, obviously, it's taking off a little bit of pressure for Jan, and I think they're quite happy with that. One thing is that you have to win, then you also have to win with games or points at stake as well. Then it's much more difficult. I think just a normal win here would take him through. Best of starts for the Danish, but it's still early days. Let's see. But Srikanth is playing with lots and lots of confidence, and the way the shots he's choosing and all that is showing lots of confidence. You know, to both of the players, my advice is obviously not to win the first game.
Well, all five previous matches this afternoon have gone to three games, and four of them, whoever wins the first has ended up losing.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Don't win the first.
Two,
yeah.
Six.
That's my best advice so far.
Oh my goodness, he almost fell over.
He did, he lost footing there. His defense is better than Jan's and his attack is better than Jan's. So, you know, this is really big trouble for Jan Jorgensen at the moment.
Okay, we'll give him that, Morten. As a player, as a coach, you can't say 11 points into the match, well, my opponent's better than me, better defense, better attack. there's no hope here. What do you have to say to yourself? I know somehow you've got to find a way, but what do you say to yourself? Let's try something completely different, or do you stick to the game plan?
I still stick to the game plan. It's too early days. See if we can work his way in. But it would be nice for Yan if he can get a few easy points. At the moment, he's not getting any easy points at all. I think Yan has to try to play the net and see whether he can get easy points somehow. This is the first flat exchange he's winning.
Yeah.
For 10.
Yeah, didn't even watch it land.
11-4.
Off to the hip box at the side of the courts. Knew that was going well along.
Men ikke 100% vinder, vel? Så 95% vinder. Det er mening?
Ja, ja.
Okay, godt. Så er det godt at få slipsaven med på, sådan så han ikke kan få lov til at rulle. Hvis du skal save kort, så giv ham lidt ekstra fart, så det bliver svært for ham at lægge den ind. Ja. Og så må du gerne slås med ham om kroppen. Altså gå ind i det flade og tryk ham på kroppen. Bare svar igen på ham.
Der kommer en lille smule mere, ikke?
Ja,
men ikke for vildt.
Well, I'm interested to know what put me out of my suspense. What was
your
coach?
Misery.
Yeah, what was Coach Larson saying?
Yeah, but you know, he wants Yan to take the fight around the body, which means the flat exchange. Obviously, so far I think Yan has lost 5 and won 1, but that's where Jesper wants him to focus a bit and then play the flick serve a few more times, and you know, that's just
mix it up.
Very basic. But and then he wants Yan to attack not 100% but a 90-95%, so he's still in good balance. But these clears and all that is just giving Srikanth far too much time. He's got all the time in the world. Yan has to play faster, he's got to push the pace a lot more. In as I see it, because Srikanth has got just too much time. Look at that, he can play that shot and then the shorter lift and then finish with a good smash. See, that's better. Those clears were better, those lifts were better. Much more pace and purpose. And suddenly Srikanth did not have the same time to play his shots.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, that's really good play, good defense by Srikanth.
Yeah. And you were saying, I think it was yesterday, Morten, how much you thought his defensive play had improved.
Yeah, that was his really weak point just 12 months ago.
Yeah. Clever. Didn't panic. Just calmly. Played the shuttle deep into the backhand corner.
den og serve.
Yeah, very good judgment. Good call, line judge too. Yeah, just wide.
Service server. 8-17.
So too is that. Well, there's a couple of the easy points that you were talking about.
See, that's a good play by Yen. That's what I want. Take the challenge, really go up there. Take the challenge at the net. Try to win these exchanges up here. This is good play. Obviously, it's too late for this first game, I'm sure. But let's see how it will all pan out in the second. But Yen really have to start to challenge. Once again there, that's a good challenge. That's going out.
Set this out. 18-10.
Oh, look at that defense. The lucky net call for Jan Jorgensen.
Even Kubichan was smiling, you know, what can you do?
18.
But that shot there, that was good.
Oh, my goodness. That is absolutely delicious. I could not tell where that was going. And look at that disguise. Unbelievable. Been going for 15 minutes, and there's already game point opportunities for K.Srikanth Kadambi.
Yeah, that has been an awesome display, I think, by K.Srikanth. And once again, I'm amazed, I'm at awe how much he has improved this year.
Yeah. It's difficult to really put into words, you know, if you're 47 at the start of the year on the world ranking, to get up to number six.
You have no idea how far that is.
No,
I know. In 1 year. It can take you 3 years to go from 15 to 10.
Yeah.
And he goes from 46 or 47 to 6.
Yeah.
In 1 year.
And mark my words, next week he'll go up even higher because he's got no points to defend from last year's Super Series finals. So when these results are added into the equation, he will go up. I wouldn't mind betting. He'll at least consolidate his place, but he might go up.
Yeah, he might go one, perhaps even two up.
Yeah.
That means that Tago and Jan Jorgensen, really, Sugiyato, that's the three.
Yeah.
Have to watch out.
Yeah. No.
But this is good for Jan.
Yeah. Four game points saved. Look at that. Short. Oh, he's missed it. Well, have we jumped ahead of ourselves?
No, I don't think so. I don't think so. I don't think Jan can save this one.
Well, good umpiring, not allowing Srikanth off court to towel down. Says no, play on. Quite right, too. Well.
17-6.
Game points have been saved. Does the Indian get a little bit nervous? Oh, he's looking back to his coach.
Yeah, he is getting nervous.
Yeah.
He is getting nervous, but he still have three good options here, so let's see.
Yeah. This time, and a smile from the 21-year-old Indian. 21-17. 18 minutes, and he's one game to good against the world number three, Jan Jorgensen.
Der er masser endnu, ja. Også selvom jeg spiller skidt i første.
Fordi han vil gerne have, at du åbner, så slår han kontra på dig, ikke?
Ja, lad os se, hvad
han vil gerne have, at du står, at han kan stå tilbage og vente på, at du løfter.
Ja.
Når du bliver overspillet, så er det rigtig godt her, hvis du siger, så bare bånd til den. Ned ind i banen med den, flat ind i banen, ikke blødt ind i banen. Hårdt ind i banen, og så ind og spille videre.
Det er virkelig vigtigt, at han ikke får tid i sin angreb på sin forbanen, så hælder jeg altså efter.
Og så skal vi skal ikke, når vi har løftet ham ned foran Sjøren, skal vi ikke smide ham kryds langt. Han flyver han over i. Hvorimod, at hvis du bare kan dreje ham lidt, så bare ind i banen igen, eller kort.
Ja.
Okay?
Ja, han skal have flere ture.
Ja, gerne. Men nu skal vi vise ham her fra start af, så kører vi bare på.
Call of 20 seconds, clear indication for the players to return to court. Well, a little bit of a wobble at the end of that opening game from Srikanth Kidambi.
Second game, love all play.
It's going wide, but presumably that run of six straight points, six game points saved by this man, Jan Jorgensen, has lifted his spirits and pleased the coach.
Yeah, both.
Yeah.
It definitely lifted Jan. I think had he lost 21-11, it would have been devastating for him. But the fact that he managed to save that many game points, and as he said, you know, I have not played well, but I still managed to get to 17. So, you know, he's sort of feeding on that. But apart from that, all what you and I have discussed, Jill, it's exactly what the Danes are talking about. Pace, making sure he's not having time. When I say he, Srikanth is not having time for his attack. He must be pushed. And once again, Srikanth is feeding off the counter-attacking situation.
Yeah.
So Jan have to avoid that as much as possible to give away the initiative. Just, you know, keep working. So a lot of the same what we discussed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
an example where Srikanth gets too much time. That clear there is so slow, gives Srikanth lots of options and time to play. That's another one, but that's set up very nicely at the net, so there's nothing you could do.
2-3.
He was off balance after landing, falling out of court there.
And from the interval, I expect that Srikanth will attack Jan Moore on the body, because I think Gubichan really indicated that Jan is very low in his defense, and therefore chances of attacking the body is quite good. Yeah. So I'm interested to see whether that will happen.
Yep.
Well, the umpire saying to Jan Jorgensen, just calm down. I don't think that was too offensive.
Sepisola. 5-4.
But it's always good when an umpire just calms the situation before it boils over.
6-4.
Okay, I think this time Jan was lucky. The first clear he played was really good, but this clear here is giving once again ample time. Good shot.
8-4.
I just get a little sense that the tide is turning.
It is. I think if I was Srikanth now, I would really try to change pace and try to go in and dictate. He's been so good, able to score the points almost at will in the first game. But now he's got to work a lot harder, so he's got to opt it as well. He's got to add on more pressure, more pace. Cannot just sit back and wait. He's got to take more initiative now as well, like that. Unfortunate he's not winning that one, but that's what he's got to do.
9-5.
I really do feel this is a very, very important little phase within the match. Oh, that's good.
Sepisola, 10-6.
Yeah, Jan is really trying to stress Srikanth at the moment. He is running up, fetching the shuttles. He's ready to serve. He's ready to receive. He is really trying to stress him between points.
Yeah. Well, he has his reward in that he's got a 5-point advantage here at the mid-game interval of the second game.
Yeah, Han håber han på, at han kan sætte den der, ikke også hver gang der. Hvis de kan nå den, og så dreje den lidt ind mod midten, ja, så er det rigtig godt. Så vi ved med at vise ham, Pian.
Det er sådan, at vi kan bringe væk, og så 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 vi kan bringe væk,
Ja, men stadigvæk. Stadigvæk.
Smid ham ind.
Specielt for min, specielt for min forhold. Ja.
Slice on that to keep it in.
Yeah, especially that one was one of the shots they discussed in the interval, and Jan have to play towards the center and not block it straight, but towards the center, or if he can get it cross court, because it's necessary he's doing that, because Srikanth is really following up very nicely and has done that on many occasions already on that forehand side. See, that's the one. That's exactly the one. Variation, very good variation. It was an investment.
On the drop shot. Just explain that a little bit more, Morten. What do you mean that was an investment, that cross-court drop shot?
First of all, it's obviously showing Jan that it's not a smash coming everything a single time. Secondly, you can't just, you know, move backwards and try to defend as well as you can, because the drop shots can come as well. So it's that whole variation. Secondly, obviously, it's on the physical level. It's a lot harder to start having to retrieve shots like that. So it's got two purposes.
Yeah. So it doesn't matter that it's not the winner. It's sending a message.
It's sending a message, and it's a good investment. He did not win it, but had he smashed, he might not have won that either. So.
Yeah.
14-8.
That's a 6-point advantage now. Immediately apologises.
16-9.
Yeah, but he earned it.
Very much so.
He played a good rally. That one was a very, very good shot.
That wasn't too shabby either, was it?
No, that's the favourite. That's the favourite shot. And that's from the forehand side and then straight down the line is perhaps Jan's best shot. So will it come true? Don't win the first game.
Just wide.
10-18.
Oh, that's nice. But high backhand clear.
Yeah, but Jan, he was pushing forward there. Yeah. He was pushing forwards, covering the nets, but the net shot he played was not tight enough. That's why he was able to flick it and he got in trouble.
Yeah, another net cord for the Dane.
Yeah, can't 19, really complain about that.
12.
So it's one game more.
That's a quick men's singles considering they play two games. And it's in what, 33 minutes?
33 minutes. Very quick.
Holder vi fast i den her taktik med, vi skal passe på med kun at køre ham kort, fordi så får han for mange valgmuligheder. På en måde, hvis du lægger ham ind imellem, ind i banen også, så bliver det sværere for ham. Og vi stadigvæk holder fast i, at spilcentrum ligger langt fremme. Når han overspiller, så klapper vi den ind i banen, og så spiller vi videre derfra. Ikke også? Ind i banen med ham igen, og så holder vi ham kort. Ind imellem selvfølgelig overspiller ham også, hvis han rykker for langt frem. Ja. Så her i starten af tredje sæt, der vil han lige prøve at se, om han kan blæse hul, ikke også?
Ja, for ellers slipper.
Ja.
Hvad skal vi ved med at sidde der nu?
Så vi skal mase tempoet op på fødderne.
Ja.
Ikke også? Virkelig have gang i benene. Ja. Og så, men vi bliver ved med at være den her tempo.
Well, that was a little bit of a worried expression on the face of Pulela Gopichand.
Ja, og han har, altså han har vundet gruppen, så det er bare at holde på.
Ja. Så, kom så.
And even when you don't understand the language, the upbeat talk there between the two Danes, very telling, very revealing.
Seconds. Yeah, they were very happy with it, and excuse me. And they just want to keep the same tactic. Obviously, needless to say, it's so important to have a good start. But I think Jan said the key word at the very end when he walked on court. He has already qualified by winning the first game.
Yeah. And just to elaborate on that, of course, Jan Jorgensen has to win because he's only 1-1.
Yeah.
And
Momota
is 1-2. Yeah. So he must win. But by my calculations, if Jan Jorgensen does win this in the three, he's done enough. Because I think his win-loss record on games will be 5-3, which is better than Momota, which I think is 5-4.
Love.
Yeah, but that's, you know, we talked a lot about that when Momota played. And I kept saying that he shot himself in the foot. Yeah. He had the chance and he really shot himself. And he's going to pay for it now.
Yeah.
Three, love.
You know, at 2011 in that first game, and K.Srikanth missed, I think it was three relatively easy smashes.
Yeah.
And it went through my mind as the bubble burst. And I think that, you know, it's a very good point. He has already qualified by winning that first game. Will he really, really fight for this? Or whether he can, whether that bubble of confidence has been burst now and you struggle to get it back.
Yeah, it's hard to say. It's very hard, but what a start from Jan.
Yeah.
But Jan is playing a completely different pace now. It's so different to the first game he played.
Yeah.
Hold.
Yeah, it's a good smash.
But it is interesting if you really look at it. Jan is stepping up towards the front of the court in order to be quick on the first third of the court. Obviously, that's opening off at the back. But have you noticed how Jan is getting out of that every single time? He's simply playing a fast, flat shot.
Flat over the net.
Flat over the net. Never mind whether it's side, down the sideline, or just play fast, flat into the court. And Srikanth can't do anything about it. So Jan is gaining initiative at the front of the court, at the net. If he's having to retrieve on these attacking lifts, then just go back, play flat hard, and get back into it and work from there. And he's getting out of it every single time. And Srikanth have to try to find an answer to that. And that's not what he's doing. He's not finding an answer at the moment. Here it comes.
Yeah.
That was actually too soft. But it's the same principle. 7-1.
Crikey, they really aren't taking any time in between rallies, are they?
No, that's wonderful.
Yeah, this is the way it should be.
It's 1.
I want to win and really put in the effort. I think it's really nice when I see Gopichan, he's concerned for his player. He's obviously not concerned about this match as such. Gopichan is through, he's in the semi-final, never mind. But he's concerned in the way that he wants his player to learn from this experience.
Yeah.
And I like that a lot.
Srikanth needed to find some answers.
And he's doing that in the flat exchanges at the moment. So what he's doing is he's having a tough reply on the fast shot that Jan is playing from the baseline. And that's what he should do. Yes.
And the other thing I've noticed,
Sabisola,
he's not trying to play so tight to the net. Mm. He's just playing a metre and a half
away
from the net. So that it makes it very difficult for the Dane then to play a tight spinning net shot in reply.
Yes.
Challenge that, absolutely. Well, there's been an overrule from the umpire. It was called in. I thought it was clearly in. Jan Jorgensen thinks it's in because he's handed the shuttle back, and because the umpire overruled, it means that now Srikanth has to use one of his challenges to prove
the umpire wrong.
To prove the umpire wrong. I watched it land. I've got a perfect view of that line, and
it's
I'm
in,
convinced
it's
in. How can the umpire overrule that? Well, we all make mistakes. Me more than most. So what am I saying? Yeah. Well, that's a nice gesture of Jan Jorgensen as well, because he handed the shuttle back, and I have to say, Vittinghus did
the same yesterday.
Yeah, good sportsmanship from both the Danish men's singles players.
And now it's heating up, isn't it?
It isn't it.
you see, that was the principle of what I talked about. He's playing that fast, flat shot. And Srikanth had to find answers to it.
Yeah. Well, with seven of the last 8 points going to Srikanth, he certainly has found answers, hasn't he? The last 9 points. Would you believe it? I thought it was all but over at 9-1.
I thought so too.
Yeah, I was talking about the bubble of confidence having burst. It is a fascinating sport of ours, isn't it?
It is.
The twists and the turns.
That's why it's so good, isn't it?
Yeah. That's why we love sport altogether. It's so unpredictable. It is the dame who has the advantage, a two-point advantage, as they change ends. Now, an interesting thing right at the start of the match, Jan Jorgensen chose ends.
Yes, he did.
I wonder if that might prove to be a crucial decision.
Yeah, he complained before.
Yeah.
And now he's complaining again.
Yeah. Doesn't like the fact that Srikanth had a verbal celebration, which he felt might influence the line judge. Well, Srikanth is challenging the line call. I have to say, the line judge at the back of the court there has been magnificent so far.
It's out.
Yeah.
Sorry.
And she's right again.
Challenge unsuccessful goal. One challenge remaining.
That's out. That's out.
13-9.
Yeah. Now that's good to see as well from the Dane.
Yeah. I think that was late, asking for the shuttles to be changed. That's good play by Srikanth.
Second serve. Ten, 13.
Good defense by Jan. That was a difficult one. His forehand defense is really working well at the moment. Three in a row.
Oh, that's good.
But once again, a good lift.
Yeah, it was, wasn't it?
This is a very good rally.
goodness.
Again, the forehand defense is working well.
Missed it. What a rally.
15-10.
And is this the decisive move?
Yeah,
look at the raised arm, the celebration, and that's very, very telling. I have to say that you and I made comment when he won the Indonesian Premier Super Series event, 41 shots, my goodness me, that what was so good about Jorgensen was the lack of celebration, the focus into every single point, not thinking ahead of himself.
No, not giving anything away. He just played every single point, as you said.
Advantage 16-10. Looking very good for the Dane, and your your theory about
don't win the first game, don't win it. Obviously, it's a joke, but
yeah,
I think Jan is playing well now. And in under normal circumstances, 16-10 in the third should be enough to win.
Yeah,
but we never know. That's good play.
A super smash to end. Forced the short lift by the tight spinning net shot.
And I think that's where Jan have to watch out now, because I think Srikanth is prepared to take the chances at the net now. So I think Jan should push him away from that net as much as possible. Play it into the court. Not too close, like that, into the court. This is trouble. So Jan has to keep playing into the court with patience. Don't try to go for some easy ones. He will not get them. Like that.
Yeah.
Now trouble.
Oh, that's nice. Oh, look at that. Oh, he's got it back. He's got
it. It's in.
And he's landed in.
It's in.
7-7. 17.
Was that an important point?
Massive.
Massive. But that's well played by Srikanth. He is desperately unlucky.
His jump there, I think.
Yeah. Imagine it had been 14, 16 and not 13, 18 now.
18-13.
Well, a good net shot from Jorgensen.
Yeah, this one here.
Yeah.
And good to see him covering the net and not moving back. Believing in his shot, that's great. And that's the time to do it when it really gets close here.
Yeah, swallowed up again. And he's got 20, six match point opportunities. 14. Six opportunities to book his place, if my calculations are right, in the semi-finals.
Yeah, I think we're seeing the two players going forward to the semi-final here.
Yeah. But Jorgensen has to close it out. He has to win. Oh, another net cord, he's done it.
Yeah.
Coming from a game deficit. 17-21, 21-12, 21-14, and that's lovely sportsmanship. Oh, terrific. It was played in good spirit. And what a good match it was too. 53 minutes for the victory for Jan Jorgensen. And we'll get it confirmed in a moment, but I am pretty certain that he has booked a place in the semi-final, along with his opponent, Srikanth Kidambi. Well, what an extraordinary afternoon's play it's been. Six matches, all going to three games. And five of those six matches, the player who won the first game ending up losing the match. Has been terrific. Well, if my maths is correct, Jan Jorgensen has topped the group by a points difference only. He's got 20 points difference between the number of points he's won and lost, whereas Srikanth Kidambi only plus 9 points difference. And therefore, Jan Jorgensen tops Group B with Kidambi finishing second. But they do both go through, obviously, to the semi-final knockout stage tomorrow. Well, we already knew that Chen Long had qualified because, in essence, that group was down to three after Sung Wan Ho retired injured. He's joined by Hans-Christian Vietinghuis, who beat Kenichi Targo earlier today, 21-19, 21-16. So two Danes in the semi-finals of the men's singles. My goodness, what a day it's been, and what drama and what excitement throughout. Thank you. Well, it really has been a wonderful day's play. From tomorrow, there's no more second chances. If you lose from tomorrow, you're out, because it is the knockout stage from tomorrow. Semi-finals tomorrow, same time. We will be back. Morten Frost, myself, Jill Clark, and all the team. We hope for your company tomorrow. In the meantime, bye for now.